Welcome back to Character Select, Dave and Space.
This is, 2-bit brain. That is stabby.
So, this is going to be a very different case, specifically because this was designed to use the DS. So the graphics are slightly higher, are slightly better. There's mechanics that are not introduced, and,
Does that look like Mia?
It does, but it's not.
Oh.
Yeah, Mia is still super dead.
Super dead.
It's been 2 months since Maya left the office. 2 months without a single trial. I've had offers, but none I took. That is, until the day that girl showed up. February 22nd, 10.02 a.m., right in company law offices where he's clearly not making any money. Like, there's no way he's going to be like,
I've been offered cases, but I decided not to take them.
Why do I come here to the office every day? It's not like I want to work. There you are, finally! Where have you been? My sister's trial is tomorrow!
Why does this sound so familiar?
Who are you? Doesn't matter who I am, it only matters who you are! The famous defense attorney, Mia Fey!
What?
Oh, you're not Mia Fey, are you? I'm sorry, but Miss Mia Fey is no longer works here.
She's only been dead, like, a year?
It's more like, 6 months.
Her blinking is... It did the right eye then the left eye. That was weird.
Did it?
I don't know if you... Yeah, look. Left eye, right eye.
No,
wait,
it's...
For it. It's on the sequence. Wait. Next. And this one.
I think you're crazy, actually.
It's on a cycle. Wait. That'll be on a loop. Wait for it. One of them's out of sync. I'm not crazy. You're crazy.
I mean, that's objectively true.
There it is. Especially you, Dave.
So you are the coffee boy? I'm Phoenix Wright, a defense attorney. Right. Wait. You're the Phoenix Wright? The Phoenix Wright from the Edgeworth murder case? Yes, that's correct. It wasn't Edgeworth who was murdered, though. That's a relief, then. You're better than nobody. I'm sorry. I'm afraid I'm not taking cases right now. But you are Phoenix Wright, right? The undefeated defense attorney? Look, I'm not accepting any new cases. I'm sorry, but you'll have to try elsewhere. Please, I'm out of time. But please, you have to help. It's my sister. Maya? Could it be? Okay, I'll hear you out. Really? Thank you so much! My name's Emma Sky. I'm a scientific investigator. Scientific investigator? Prepare for people to talk ad nauseum about scientific investigation. Heavy quotation marks.
So Emma, it's...
See? Look, the quotation marks are already starting.
I'm getting some lag from you.
Oh. Go ahead and reconnect.
No, it's the voice.
Oh. I can't help you with that.
Okay.
Emma, was it? So you're a scientific investigator?
I did the left and then the right.
I don't believe you. Yes, that's right. Is something wrong? No, it's just... You seem kind of, jumpy. Or maybe just young? Young? I'll be 16 years old this year. Oh, I see. Wait, only 16? I'm set to be formally assigned to forensics in 3 more years. My work is becoming quite well known, at my age, no less. So what exactly is your current position, then? Well, legally speaking, I guess you'd call me an 11th grader.
No.
But I'm ready to do my job, at my age, no less. Great, another future professional in training. So what's this about a case? You said the trial's tomorrow?
My sister didn't do it. She wouldn't stab someone with a knife. She wouldn't.
So, it's a murder case.
I don't care if there's a witness who saw her do it. She didn't do it. I know she didn't do it. It's a scientific fact.
And there's a witness.
Just talk to her. You have to talk to her.
Right. I suppose I will.
I promised her I'd bring Mia Faye, but...
That's interesting. How would she know Mia? So,
and,
there's
and,
a witness...
It obviously said Riot and Company law offices on the building. Not...
So, fun fact about Emma. She's training to be a scientific investigator, a forensic analyst, essentially.
Yeah.
And she misses incredibly obvious details, like the name that's written on the door. So
she's like, Maya, just with a reskin.
She's like Maya with no excuses. So you want to be a scientific investigator when you grow up, then?
Excuse me? I'm not a child, I'll have you know.
Still, it's good to have a goal, albeit a very unusual one.
I believe investigation should be done scientifically. Don't you?
Yeah. Sure can't fault her lack of enthusiasm.
If this case is handled scientifically, I'm sure my sister's name will be cleared.
Your sister?
I've been doing research, you know. I'm developing a new scientific method of case investigation.
Oh,
I'll show you when I'm done.
I'm looking forward to it. Guess I should get down to the detention center and talk to her sister. But let's ask her this last question. Click on it. Thank you.
My sister asked for Mia specifically. This Mia Faye person was a few years below her in school.
So they went to the same school, huh?
She always told me to go to Mia if I ever needed a defense attorney. And, well, I need one.
Incidentally, Mia is a woman.
Now that you mention it, I guess it is more of a woman's name than a man's.
Okay.
Well, it's nice of you to help your sister out like this. You must be close.
Well, actually, when she gets like she is now, I kind of hate her.
Huh?
But she's my only family.
Your only family? What about your parents?
They died in a car accident when I was little.
Oh, I'm sorry. All right, well, off we go to the detention center. So the thing about this case is because this was developed after the third Phoenix Wright game came out.
Yeah.
Or the third Turnabout Attorney, I guess, game, because that's what it's called in Japan. They couldn't create a storyline that interfered with the existing storyline. So they introduced new characters and all that stuff to get it all set up. And then they don't reference this game again until Apollo Justice, Ace Attorney, which is the fourth game.
When so Emma this case
yeah.
isn't mentioned until...
Yes.
Okay. This is completely irrelevant right now. This is just
it's
extra
like, well, like, you'd sit there and you'd be like, so we don't have to do this story, do we? No, you have to do the story, because this has one of the best payoffs ever. Even better than Von Karma. I wonder what's wrong with Emma. She got quiet all of a sudden as soon as we arrived. This is going to be her sister. Guard, I thought I told you I didn't want visitors. Go for it.
Oh. Sorry, ma'am. It's... just... your sister.
No excuses. Or did you not want to raise this here, hmm?
Understood, ma'am.
What was that about? Hi, Lana.
Funny. I seem to remember specific telling you not to come here. Perhaps my memory is failing?
Look, I didn't want to come here either, okay? But your trial's tomorrow and you still don't have a defense attorney.
I'll be the one in court tomorrow. This has nothing to do with you, Emma. Isn't that right, Mr. Wright?
Hey, how do you know me?
Mia mentioned you. I've heard... quite a bit. I'm sorry. What exactly is it that you do?
My name is Lana. Lana Sky. I'm chief prosecutor for this district.
You're a prosecutor? Two sisters. One a lawyer. Could this be a coincidence? Emma. Lana. I mean, they're just like...
Is something wrong, Mr. Wright?
So she's the
a little bit.
She's the chief prosecutor, and she's convicted. Or she's been arrested for murder. After we took down the unimpeachable, extremely guilty best prosecutor. So now the chief prosecutor is on trial. It's probably not good.
Nah.
There's something you should know from the start, which is the suspect in this case has confessed to the crime. Huh?
Wait, but the suspect is...
me. I did it. Well, Mr. Ray? Well, why don't you begin by telling me exactly what happened? The crime took place yesterday, February 21st at 5:15 p.m. That's quite specific. It was in the witness's deposition. A witness clearly saw me committing the crime. My, that was a bit of bad luck, wasn't it? The crime took place in the underground parking lot at the prosecutor's office. The body was found in the trunk of my subordinate's car. Prosecutor's office, huh? In your subordinate's car trunk? Classy. I was arrested on the spot, caught red-handed, as it were. Well, that's just great. So who was the victim? An investigator with the police department. I suppose the correct term is detective.
A detective?
Death was due to a loss of blood. He was stabbed once on the stomach. By... you? Death wasn't immediate, but the wound was fatal. I see. Allow me to repeat myself, Mr. Wright. The victim was a detective. You know what that means, don't you? Uh-oh.
What? Mr. Wright, what does it mean? What do you think?
I don't know.
In the U.S., I'm not sure if it's the same in Australia. I don't think you guys have the death penalty, do you?
No.
In the U.S., a capital crime, such as killing a police officer, also that, but they'll use any means at their disposal to do so. This case gets worse and worse with everything I learn. If she's convicted, she's going to be put to death. So you're the chief prosecutor? That is correct. I'm responsible for overseeing every trial handled by prosecutors in this district. I make sure the prosecutors have what they need to do the job and manage every aspect. Those are my responsibilities in a nutshell. That's an awfully large nutshell. Still, I'm a little surprised. I would think you'd recognize the district's chief prosecutor, Mr. Wright. Huh? In fact, it seems impossible that you wouldn't.
Lana? What happened to your hand?
Oh, this? I cut myself by accident. When I stabbed him, that is.
Huh?
I'm not very good at being a criminal, I suppose.
How am I supposed to defend this?
Time to change the subject. Wait, she was in the class ahead of Mia, wasn't she? You were in school with Mia, correct? A few years above her? Emma told you that too, did she?
Well, why not? I did drag him all the way here from his office.
Although it seems he has very little in common with Mia.
Hey!
It was in law school. I was in my third year, and she was auditing the class. She was different than the other students.
Different?
She was strong. She'd do anything to become a defense attorney. Anything. That was probably why she was attracted to me.
Excuse me? Intellectually attracted. Lana was the top of her class in school.
I don't know, maybe they kind of had a thing. You don't know. I was the best there was.
Oh. I'm doing pretty good in school too, by the way.
Sounds a bit different when Emma says it.
Well, Mr. Wright?
Excuse me? As you can plainly see, I am admitting my guilt. I think it's safe to say there's no way you can take this case.
None. But Lana... why? Why are you doing this to me? You never think of anyone but yourself. I know you didn't do it, Lana. I know. So how can you say you did? If I lose you, I'll be all alone. I hate you, Lana.
Mr. Wright?
Yes?
I believe our discussion here has ended. The rest, I leave to you.
Oh, okay. That's fine.
You mean you're requesting my services as your defense?
Don't lose any sleep over it. Your client has confessed, after all. The case is over.
Right. I'll do what I can to get to the bottom of this. Lana's confessed to the crime, yes, but something doesn't fit. It's that look in Emma's eyes. There's something else going on here, and I'm gonna find out what.
Well, it's obviously blackmail.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wright. Huh? About what? My sister, she's not always like that, you know? I just never expected to be defending another prosecutor again. She's changed a lot. She used to be so gentle, always smiling. Everyone liked her. I see. Sorry, but I'm having trouble imagining that. What happened to her? I don't know for certain myself. I think maybe she... Well, maybe not. Sounds like there's something there that defies a simple scientific explanation. Let's go check out this underground parking at the prosecutor's office, shall we? Okay. Alright, let's get to investigating, now that we have the backstory.
Yeah, and we're just bringing her along?
Apparently. So this is the lot where it all happened?
Looks like they're still investigating.
Funny that my first visit to the prosecutor's office should be like this.
Hey everyone, keep up the good work!
Hey, what are you thinking?
Well, they are going to be my co-workers 3 years from now, after all. No harm in saying hello.
Actually, there is. You know attorneys aren't supposed to examine crime scenes? Since fucking when? I mean, I'm pretty sure we've been doing that the whole time.
I mean, you've been here to, like, every single...
I'm trying not to stand out too much here, see? Oh, no, it's not.
You partner? Partner? What? What do we have here? Looks like Bambina got loose from the ranch. It's up to no good. Folks gotta learn to keep their doggies tied down.
This guy is so fucking McCree. It hurts.
Mr. Marshall!
Okay, I'll just shave.
Marshall looks more like a sheriff to me.
Look here, Bambina. I know how you feel. This is my gang's gold strike, see?
Strike?
This is our claim. Should I change the voice? Our territory. Mother load of evidence. I don't know.
Do whatever
you're
you
fixing a mess with its eyes. You regret it, partner. I'm reading it before. You know what dreams? The cacti out in the desert dream? You wanna?
What's this guy talking about?
You head along home now. Happy trails, Bambina. What?
Was that, Hombre a friend of yours?
kinda. Sorta. Yeah. He's a detective.
Who thinks he's a sheriff from the Wild West, it seems.
Right.
Alright, well, let's take a look around. This seems obvious.
What's this? A wallet?
Excuse me, officer?
Wait, what are you doing, Mr. Wright?
What am I doing? I just found this wallet, so I'm handing it over to the police.
I don't believe it. This is real basic. Anything at a crime scene is evidence. Let's be scientific about this, please. Just put it in your pocket.
How is that scientific? Sounds like theft to me.
I'm called to duty already, and at my tender age. Here, I'll teach you the trick to examining evidence in detail, okay? Okay, now, look at the court record.
So...
Great.
Now, because there's DS stuff, there was like a 3D screen and all that?
Yeah. From every angle.
I'm sorry.
With HMBM.
What the fuck? Oh, those are the worst controls.
Oh, look, there might be a clue. Okay.
This is an ID card. Sergeant Bruce Goodman, ID 4858-42189. I guess, though I don't see what science has to do with it. Goodman's ID added to the court record.
Let's be sure to examine every piece of evidence we find.
It's got to be on my toes from now on. So yeah.
We just tossed the wallet back. And,
basically.
Exactly.
Whoop. Anyway, there's the crime scene.
Okay. There's, like a Walkman on the floor.
Yeah. Well, no time to waste. Let's get hunting for clues. Huh, I wonder what this is.
Well, partner, looks like you got no intention of going home quietly.
The sheriff.
Like I said before, this here's our plane. That's been worse. You'd best be nose in the log. Unless you're inflicted by the bullet.
Yeah, scary. Could you just tell us one thing? Who owns that car?
I forgot I had to do voices for this. So I'm like, completely unprepared. Well, little Philly's got a good nose on her. You want to know who rides that red Mustang with Buddy in her satellite?
Please.
No problem, Warner. About time for Vittles anyway. What?
About time
to the
for
saloon up on the 12th floor of the prospector's office.
Yeah, basically he's saying it's time for me to take a break anyway.
Not just find you cerveza like you. You like
is that cerveza is Spanish for beer.
Okay, he keeps speaking Spanish, so I'm like
prosecutor's office? Where does this guy think he is? And when, for that matter?
I feel like doing a Spanish sort of sounding voice is a bit racist.
Note to self, look up Vittles Saloon Cerveza. Maybe we should check out room 1202, the High Prosecutor's Office.
In any case, stay away from the car. You can look around here all you like, just keep your paws off.
Right, great.
Great, maybe there's some clues around here, Mr. Wright. Let's check it out. Excuse me? Were you two all set? Us?
Hi, boobs. What's this? She couldn't be.
You're selling lunches? Here? This is a crime scene. Hello. Half and half, was it? Oh, thanks. And you, sir?
Yes?
Some crunchy goodness coming at you.
Thanks? Interesting way of doing business.
This area is off limits to anyone without clearance. Especially passerby. Or are you officers?
There's donuts in our hat.
They're, rice balls.
No, but
you... You know what I mean.
You don't exactly look like the type to have clearance.
Well, that's hardly a way to greet someone. Even if my days as the cough-up queen are over.
Cough-up? Huh? You know, I'm feeling kind of full. Maybe I'll pass on lunch.
Cough-up, of course, being another term for vomiting or barfing.
I'm quite connected to this case, you see. The images are burned into my eyes, you might say. Yes. All the sordid secrets. Secrets? Dear me, you are a slow one, aren't you? I'm referring to the murder, the stabbing of that detective. What?
Yeah. Flashback.
You mean you're the witness my sister was talking about? Please, cough up, Queen, tell us what happened. The name is Angel Star. Don't you go forgetting it. Oh, but before you know it, I'll have you whimpering at my heels.
Right.
Yes, ma'am. She means it. Okay.
Somehow I knew. Yesterday was a day of destiny. I knew something was going to happen. Just like I know that the daily special on Friday every week is salmon.
Destiny? Was yesterday special for some reason? You're a defense attorney, right? You should know then.
You should know the foul misdeeds of the evil ones who haunt this den of iniquity.
Evil ones?
What?
Prosecutors. They have no qualms at all about blackening the name of innocence. And yesterday they paid homage.
Homage, sorry.
Yesterday they paid homage to the most evil one of all. They gave an award for King of Prosecutors. What a farce.
So she's saying there was some sort of prosecutor's convention yesterday.
I was almost compelled to lace their lunches with something foul. Do you have a personal grievance against prosecutors or something? Or is there some kind of scientific evidence of this, evil? Youngness, mock me at your own risk. You'll soon find out why they call me the cough-up queen. Ew! The most heinous of all the evil ones, the one they awarded yesterday, It was in his car that they found the body. Proof that he devours the evilest lunches of all. Really?
Really what? I'm totally confused.
Yeah.
One thing's clear, this lunch lady is a thing against prosecutors.
So, what exactly is it that you witnessed, Miss Star? It was a fascinating spectacle, to be sure. I now feel I know what they say when they talk about a woman's wrath. To see Lana Skye wield that knife so... Her knife flashed in anger, bringing him to a sad end. It was truly a sight to see. You mean you saw the very moment of the crime? The sound of his silvery ties to this world being cruelly cut still rings in my ears. And the rhythmic beat of Lana Skye's knife. Wait a second, you know Lana Skye?
Well, so hang on. It was one stab. What do you mean rhythmic beat of a knife?
Well, I guess we're going to find out. Of course, it's quite a feat becoming chief prosecutor. How many lunchboxes of sin did she pack to make that journey, I wonder?
Oh, what?
She always travels late. Now, why would this pretty lunch lady know the chief prosecutor's name? Could we ask you a bit about yourself, Miss Star? I come here every day to sell lunches. I import only the fresh and best from the Far East.
Okay.
For some reason, the box lunches are a hit here. Why not make the lunches here rather than import them? Did you say something?
Sir, did you say Lox Bunches?
Lox Bunches. Did I?
I don't know.
I might have.
I'm hearing things.
You're hearing things, you're seeing things. I think you're on the crazy pills again. Only true connoisseurs can understand. Ugh. The kind you can only tell someone who has tried General So's trilobite lunch set. Ugh. Never mind. You win. I don't even want to appreciate part of a trilobite's flavor. Anyway, I come here every day to sell lunches. My boyfriend works in the security room here at the prosecutor's office. Your boyfriend? See the security room over there? The glass-walled booth? Right up here. It's hard to see. I sell my lunches.
I don't know where you're pointing, but I didn't see it.
See just above her head? The red letters?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I sell my lunches, and since I'm here anyway, I drop in to see him. Since you're here anyway, I guess selling lunches is more important than romance. So, to scientifically analyze the data available so far, you, Miss Star, are a lunch vendor with an ulterior motive for coming here. Useful analysis. Not. Do you remember when not jokes were a thing? Because that's not a thing anymore. Yeah.
Yeah, probably about 25 years ago.
Maybe a little more recent than that, but still like 18 years ago, maybe. Which is coincidentally when this game came out. Did you have a bad experience with the prosecutor, Miss Star? I sense some hostility. Hostility? Perhaps. Prosecutors are all alike, and the bigger they get, the worse they smell. Kind of like 10-day-old clams in the chowder. Wonder if Miss Star was involved in some sort of legal trouble in the past. That'd be a sure cause of food poisoning. Scientifically speaking, of course. I mean, now you're talking cough up, Queen. Thought she was just a lunch vendor, but now I'm not so sure. We don't have anything that we can use to...
talk to her with. So can we actually examine the car?
No, I can't slide anymore. They're saying don't go over there. Alright, well, let's go up to the...
High Prosecutor's
Office. Next time on Character Select. So, thank you very much for watching. Make sure to click that like button down below if you liked it. In space, whose car do you think it is?
Whose car?
It's somebody that we've met before.
I have no idea.
It's gonna be a great reveal then, don't worry.